Hello everyone, and welcome to another Versus video. I am BBD, and I am joined again by...
CBM.
And we are battling Modern for GP Charlotte this weekend. And we are going to play the old Sevens game to see who goes first. But more than that, we actually only have one of the GP Charlotte Noble Hierarch playmats. So only one of us gets to use the Noble Hierarch playmat. The other one gets to settle for the still awesome Eternal Witness playmat.
The previous Modern GP that we ran. So how this is going to work is whoever wins the Seven game gets to choose to go first in the actual game of Magic.
Yep.
But then they also get to be the one who places the cards for our poison game. And the loser of the Sevens game gets to either keep them where they are or switch them. And whatever card you end up with, that's the playmat we're going to use for the video.
All right. Let's see who... I didn't roll a... see if we can...
Six.
Eight. Seven.
Oh, no.
All right, so CVM lost the Sevens game.
All right, well, you
so I'm going to get to go first, and I get to place these.
So now I have to deduce what I know about BBD, and I think that he would put the Noble Hierarch in front of me. Oh. All right, well, I guess I'll be on the E-Witness playmat.
I get to use the sweet Noble Hierarch playmat and get to go first. Really just the best of both worlds. I'm going to be battling with a Jeskai Swans deck, and CVM's playing Jund, so make sure you stay tuned for the games. All right, we're here for game number one, and I get to be on the play, which is pretty sweet, except I don't think I can keep this hand. So close to being perfect, but not quite. Yeah, I think I have to mulligan this hand, because if I don't draw a second land, I'm not going to win. But if I do draw a second land, this hand would be perfect. So
I'll... Would you keep it on the draw?
Probably, yeah. I am back on six, and I can already tell that this is going to be a keep.
Two lands and a spell?
Yeah, those are the first three. Yeah, this hand's not phenomenal, but I'm going to keep it. And start with this. You're up.
Okay. Go ahead. I'm going to lead on that. Might have been wrong, actually. Actually, yeah. I'm not going to lead on that. I'm going to lead on this instead.
Okay. All right, so unfortunately we've drawn two of our three shock lands, so our screds are going to be a lot worse, but that is the nature of the beast.
I'll fetch instead. 19. And I want to get... I think I get a red-black here. Yeah, we're gonna get a red-black. So getting red-black is a little awkward since we also have four Blackleaf Cliffs in the deck and we want to have access to green mana for Scavenging Ooze. But like, I don't have a Scavenging Ooze here, and with the texture of my hand, I'm just gonna want as many red and black colors of mana that's available. All right, and I'll draw. All right, so because we have these, I don't really want to be just doing a bunch of damage to myself with my lands. So I'm going to fetch.
Get zero at 18.
Go to 18. And here I'm going to get a swamp.
Playing against Rakdos here.
Yep. I'm sure this will get bolted, but oh well.
Go not ahead. Get bolted, it will, however, get snared by the spell.
Oh, spell snared, all right.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Spell snare is probably my least favorite card in Modern, but sometimes you do get things with it. Go.
All right. So here, we're just going to play another Bob.
I'm going to snapcast or spell snare it.
All right. Raise your Ravine and pass.
All right, and then draw here. This is really actually an awkward draw. Extremely awkward draw. I'm going to fetch down to 19. And Arid Mesa is probably the worst fetch land to draw, since it can only get us a mountain, since we have already drawn our snow-covered plains. And I really wanted an island here, but it is what it is. We could also gotten
turn on cryptic.
Could have also gotten Sacred Foundry, but
that's also not an island.
Yeah, it's also not an island. And I'm just gonna bash for two.
16.
And say go.
Drop.
Sure.
All right. Well, here we just have to pass the turn.
All right. End of turn. I'm gonna Vendilion Click.
Vendilion Click. You have two cards in hand?
Two.
All right, well, that's going to resolve.
Choose you.
I'm going to respond to that.
Colgan's Command.
Yeah, we're going to do two damage here and make you discard a card.
All right, I'll discard a Serum Visions. Oh, man.
It could have been that I could have just let that happen since I had two Culligan's commands, which I probably should have done. I don't know. I don't think there's any benefit to...
All right, well, I'm going to take the other Culligan's command because I don't really want you to cast that card. And, yeah. That is a scary hand to see. Draw.
Well, we haven't been drawing lands, so.
That's true. Let's get you.
14.
And I'm going to play a Snapcaster Mage and Flashback Serum Visions.
Sure.
All right, so we draw a card first, this one, and then we scry two. And fortunately, this is the worst one of these, again. However, it does let us play this. So maybe we want to keep it for that reason. In fact, we probably do. So yeah, I'm gonna bottom this because this card's actually fine against this hand, so maybe I wanna keep both, but I wanna just use this and play this next turn. So we'll just bottom and top. Or actually we can double top because if we fetch it doesn't matter. So yeah, we'll just double top and say go. At least he is probably going to have to use some of these removal spells on our Snapcaster Mages.
And a Raging Ravine, and then I'll pass.
Okay. Alright, so untap, we'll draw this, which we knew we were drawing, and attack you for 4.
I think that I want to bolt these. Now I'll bolt a Snapcaster Mage.
Okay.
And I'll take 2.
Alright, so you're at 12. I will fetch down to 18, get a Snow Covered Mountain, and cast Dragon Lord Ojutai.
Whoa. That is the Dragon Lord Ojutai.
Yes, it is.
Alright.
Alright, and we're going to hopefully dodge him flipping Land Liliana, which would probably be the worst possible here for us.
Come on, baby.
He does have 2 Terminates, though, so it's going to be hard for us to attack with this Ojutai, but it is going to prevent him from, like, casting spells. You're up.
All right, upkeep. Trigger Bob.
All right, Terminate.
I'll go 10. We'll draw a card.
All right, so we know that Ojutai is probably going to get terminated at some point this game.
So I think that I have to not play this and keep up mana for double terminate, which is kind of awkward. But if I do get this card in play, it's going to be very good. Which I think I'm actually fine with.
Tarmo? Or ooze. Sure.
And then I'll pass the turn.
All right. Let's see. Come on, deck. Gotta be kidding me. There's only 3 of these in the deck. and I've already drawn my 2 fetchable lands. It's just the worst possible. That's unreal. Oh man, that's a tilt right there. That is a mega tilt. Well, I can't attack, and I guess his Colgan's commands are his other commands on the bottom, but he could draw like a Liliana. So I don't think I want to even play this land, to be honest. I'll just say go.
Alright, end step, we're going to eat your Snapcaster Mage.
Alright, so you're at 11.
Yep, I'll go to 11. upkeep.
You're at 9.
Nine.
Bob is one of the better cards he could flip for us there. We'll he probably can't cast. Turn. Probably can't really play it.
Okay. So I can just attack with the scavengers, I guess. And I can trade it with his Ojitai if I really want to. 3, 4. I think I would rather wait and just attack next turn with it. So I'll just play a Regent Ravine.
Okay.
And then I'll pass the turn.
All right. Draw a card. All right. That's a card we can cast. Man. It would have been nice to draw this last turn, actually. But it is what it is. I'll just say go.
Alright, in your end step, we'll eat your Mundane Click, and I'll go to 10. And then I'll eat one of my Bobs.
11.
Go to 11. Do I want to kill this Snapcaster Mage now? I feel like I kind of just want to like save these Terminates for Swans. Which is something that I can assume that he might have since I see the snow-covered lands. Like, it's a deck that's online. Alright, upkeep, trigger.
Olivia. Liliana. Alright.
Go to 8.
Yep.
Draw a card. Alright. Let's see here. So what I think I want to do is just attack with this scavenger. See what happens. So we'll go to combat.
Okay.
Attack with scavengers.
No blocks.
I'll eat my Dark Confidant.
Okay, so you're at 9, and that I'm taking 6 down to 12.
Yep. Okay. I'll play a land, and I don't think that I want to play this Olivia here. Because he could have something like Cryptic Command. Oh, actually, you can't cast Cryptic Command. I guess he could have Stubborn Denial. I don't really think I need to cast the Olivia since I have double Terminate available. So I'll just pass the turn here.
Okay. No creatures in the graveyard.
Nope. Scryd is an instant, right?
It is an instant. Okay. All right, we'll draw a card. All right, that was a reasonable one to draw.
Oh man, now you can Cryptic.
And I still don't want to attack here, so I'm just going to pass the turn.
Okay, your end step. I will Abrupt Decay your Snapcaster Mage, and then eat it with Scavengers.
Yep, you're at 10.
Yep. Upkeep, trigger.
Yep. Whew. That's the ticket right there.
I haven't revealed a land yet. That's kind of gross. All right, so I'm at 6.
Yep. Olivia was a good one for us there.
All right, you have 3 cards in hand?
I do.
Okay. So I will go to my combat step.
Sure.
I'll attack with scavengers.
All right, so that is 7 damage.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take 7. I'm at 5.
So I'm at 6 and you're at 5.
Yep.
Okay. So I don't think that I want to do anything here. 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, 7. So I'll just pass the turn.
All right, end of your turn, I'll fetch down to 4. Get a snow-covered island. I'm going to Cryptic Command, Bouncing Scavenging Ace, and drawing a card. Draw.
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, I still have, I have to discard now.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I guess you have to discard.
I think here I can get rid of this Bob.
All right, then draw for turn. All right, well, if I attack with Archetype, it just terminates it. I'll play this, and I'll cast Swans.
Okay.
And let's tap like this. Stab like this, I guess. Nah, alright. We'll tap like this. There it is.
Okay.
Alright, cast the Swans, and I think I just say go.
And your end step. I'll terminate your Swans.
Sure, that's fine.
Take my turn?
Yep.
Upkeep, true?
Yep.
Go to 5. I was hoping to draw one of these at some point. I'll draw for turn.
Yeah.
I'll start out with an Inquisition.
I'll respond by lightning bolting you.
Alright, I go to 2.
Arid Mesa.
Right, and you're at 4?
Yep. I'm dead to a number of cards, but
so, well, I can just attack with Raging Ravine and Dark Confidant. He has to block the Raging Ravine. I don't think that does much. Actually, what I can do is I can Liliana, kill his Dragon Lord, attack him, play a Scavenging Ooze, and then eat creatures in my upkeep if he doesn't have a removal spell for Scavenging Ooze on top of his deck. So I think that's our best route to victory.
Okay.
So I'll eat it to you.
Yep.
I'll attack you for 2.
Met 2.
I'll play Cliffs, I'll cast the Scavenging Ooze, and I'll pass the turn.
All right, I'll fetch to 1. Okay, we would have died. Sometimes you just gotta roll the dice here a little bit. Come on! Snapcaster Mage. Lightning Bolt. We have a lot of dead draws. There's a few good ones. Alright, so my hand is Arid Mesa. Did you put it on the bottom?
Yeah.
Ooh, redraw. All right, we got a redraw. Serum Visions. It was a red spell. Come on.
I mean, it kills my
Oh, yeah. Ooze. It does kill your ooze. I do get the scry,
too. So then I get
too.
To live and die by the top of my library.
That's true. The scrying doesn't matter for me, but, yeah, we'll kill that ooze. get rid of a couple lands. Go. Come on.
Come on, Thoughtseize.
Or lightning bolt. Oh, no!
One to one.
I'll die. If I had drawn a non-arid Mesa land that one turn where you only had two mana up, I would have like been able to attack you with Ojatai, Cryptic Command your thing, find Bolt off of Ojatai and kill you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. All right, we're back for game two, and I get to be on the play, and this is a hand. All right, this is a hand. I'm going to keep it.
I guess I'll keep this hand, too. It's not super exciting, but we've got playable cards.
Go.
A discard spell here would be nice. Go.
Go. That was not the card we wanted to draw.
Well, no blue mana is nice. We're going to go to 19, and I think that I just get a green-red here. Could be wrong, but oh well.
Stomp it up. CVM's gonna stomp the yard.
Yeah, I think it's fine. The struggle in this deck is the fighting where you want to cast like multiple black spells in a turn in Liliana and then have useful scavenging uses later, but that was a good draw. I'll just play Turtle Breath and pass.
Okay, I'll lightning bolt it.
Boom, it's dead.
I cannot cast Scred to kill
so
it, but Lightning Bolt does kill it.
Yeah, you need to do 3 damage instead of 2.
Perfect. Go.
All right. So here, I just want to cast another Tarmogoyf.
Sure.
And this one's a 3/4.
That is true.
And then I'll pass.
Draw a card. Go.
Oh, that's not good.
It's not good.
All right. Combat.
Sure.
Battle.
Fetch. I'll go to 19. Get a island and cast Snapcaster Mage.
Snapcaster Mage. So I guess the goal here is to... He wants to bolt and block. And I think I'm fine with just... getting rid of the Snapcaster Mage and getting in damage. So I will terminate the Snapcaster Mage for 4 blocks.
Okay, I'll take 3.
I imagine you're still giving your Bolt Flashback?
Yeah, giving Bolt Flashback.
Okay, so you go to 16. And now I don't want to play this because he can just kill it with his Lightning Bolt. So we're just going to pass the turn.
Maybe I'm not supposed to bolt here in case I draw another Snapcaster, but YOLO, bolt you.
It also could be relevant to leave it in the graveyard to Harvest Spire, too.
That is true.
I'll go to 16.
Come on, top deck. All right, Serum Visions. Come on,
four,
top
five.
Attack deck. That's not it. Neither of those are it.
We need a land for some Swans action.
I will double bottom and send it back to you.
Draw. Well, we just keep drawing these, and I'm not going to complain, that's for sure. 4.
12.
Alright. So let's play. This.
Okay.
And then I'll pass the turn.
All right, come on, deck. That was probably the worst possible. Go.
Nura and step. We're gonna make green green.
Sure.
I'll eat your Snapcaster Mage.
Okay.
And I go to 17. And then I'm also going to eat my Tarmogoyf.
Okay.
I go to 18, and that strikes the Goyf to a 3-4.
Correct.
18. 18 to 12. I'll draw a card. Combat.
Sure. I'll take it. I'm at 5.
We'll play an Olivia Voltaire. We're going to play the Verdant Catacombs. I'm going to fetch
17.
I'll go to 15.
15 it is.
Because I want to get another red source.
Okay.
And then we'll play an Olivia Voltaren.
Sure.
And then I'll pass.
So this is extremely unfortunate where I have 4 burn spells in my hand and can't kill a single creature in play.
Just screds and bolts and helixes and whatnot?
We're dead. Can't cast can you only cast one spell a turn and none of them kill any of your creatures?
Yeah, well, I just drew all 3 Terminates again. Only had one in my opener.
All right, we are back for sideboarding. For myself, I'm going to be bringing in some more removal spells that are a little bit better at dealing with CVM's creatures. So we have a Purge, which is great against Liliana is the main thing that Purge is for, but can also hit Dark Confidant or Olivia, or even the Hunt Masters that he's siding in, which I didn't see those in the first game, but I would still bring in Purge regardless. Yeah. Batterskull, 4 games that go long, couple of paths that deal with giant oozes and goyfs, and then a couple explosives as well as another way to deal with oozes and goyfs. Basically, explosives is really good on 2 against that deck because he has a lot of 2 drops. Sometimes we can get like Liliana on 3 as well, but generally speaking, it's for 2.
It's also just like a card that you can play proactively.
Yep.
That you don't have to sit on like Spell Snare. Like if you're sitting on a Spell Snare, then I can take it with a discard spell and then land a 2 drop. Whereas if you just put an explosives into play on 2, then I have to play around it the entire game.
The downside to this, though, is that it does get destroyed by Kolaghan's Command and Abrupt Decay. Mm-hmm. So there is a downside to just running it out there. As for cards I'm cutting the hard-to-cast Counterflux, which also doesn't seem very good against Jund anyway. I don't like relying on counterspells against heavy discard strategies, which is why I'm also cutting a Stubborn Denial in both of my Spell Snares, and I'm leaving in 1 Stubborn Denial just as a combo with Swans, but maybe that shouldn't even be in there. Maybe it should just be the other Spell Snare or something along those lines. I'm cutting the 2 Angers because they don't really kill that much in CVM's deck. However, seeing that he's bringing in Kitchen Finks and Hunt Master, I may bring Anger back in for some of the later games if we see those cards.
Yes, for myself, I'm bringing in Hunt Master and Kitchen Finks. His deck is just full of 1-for-1 removal, so I want creatures that are sticky and just give me some value. So if he's ever, you know, bolting or scredding or pathing, you know, Huntmaster or Kitchen Finks, like I'm still getting some value out of them.
Yep.
And Address, just because his deck is a lot of spells. And I've only cast 1 discard spell in both of the pre-board games. And so bringing in 1 more, you know, hopefully we cast some more in the post-board games as it's just very good against these types of decks. As for what I'm cutting, I'm going to cut an Outpost Siege. I don't think that it's a little slow, but the way that this matchup is going to play out, there's going to be cards like Terminate that I'm going to want to sit on and use on for specific targets, and I just don't want to be like flipping my removal spells to Outpost Siege when you don't have something for me to actually remove. Very similar to like the old Jund decks where if your opponent doesn't have a board, you're usually just not going to cast your Bloodbraid Elf because you don't want to lose value on the cards that are in your deck. I'm also cutting 2 Abrupt Decay since it just doesn't actually kill anything in this deck. If I get crushed by Blood Moon in a post-board game, I'll bring it back in. But for now, I just get rid of the Abrupt Decay. Same thing with the Lightning Bolts. They just don't effectively kill anything in his deck that I can't already handle with other removal spells.
Yeah, and I'm not bringing in Blood Moons, which is interesting to note, because They're usually not that actually effective against Jund because they have a lot of basics and they have decays. And generally speaking, they're going to be fetching those, but sometimes it might be worth just trying to get them. Like, if it's a really bad matchup, sometimes, just try to get them with Blood Moon. Hope that works.
Yeah. It could be that I want to keep the bolts in just as a way to Ancestral myself if you happen to get a Swans in play. But I think that something along the lines of Cole against Command where I can just, like, do two and make you discard a card is going to be just as good as casting on.
That is pretty good.
So let's see what happens.
All right, let's do it. All right, we're back for game three, and I have the pleasure of being on the play again.
Yet again.
And this hand actually looks pretty good, so I'll keep this one.
Yeah, this hand's actually fine, so I'll keep it too.
Go.
So I think that I want to, so I can just get a swamp with this, or I can just shock myself with this, which I'm probably fine with. So we'll go to 18 and I will Inquisition.
All right, you have a choice between Lightning Bolt, Remand, and Soulfire Grandmaster.
Oh man, all right, well. This is interesting. I'm not sure which card I want to take.
So, like, could take all three of them? Kind of
yeah.
Thing? All right, well, I'm going to be fetching for a snow-covered mountain while this is going on.
Yeah.
Because I'm doing that regardless.
So I think that I want to... So I can take the Lightning Bolt. See, I think I just end up wanting to take the Remand here. Or maybe I just take the Soulfire Grandmaster.
Why don't you take the Island? I'll just go ahead and bin it for you already.
Oh. This is actually pretty tough. So I think that I actually just take the Remand.
Sure.
And then I'll pass the turn. That might be wrong.
Alright. This is what we drew. And we're just going to fetch and cast Soulfire Grandmaster. So I'm at 18. Mm-hmm. And you're up. Snow covered plains in here.
Mm, that's not a bad draw. So I think what I want to do here is I think we fetch and we just play this Bob.
Old Robert.
Old Robert. I think that we get a swamp.
All right, so you're at 17?
Yeah.
All right.
That'll be your turn.
And we'll draw, and that is our draw for turn.
So we can just get value off this whole fire with his Lightning Bolt, but not much we can do to stop that.
Yeah, we're just going to bolt that and then attack. So
you go to 21,
I go
and
to 20,
23, and I go to 15.
Yep, 23, 15, and we'll just pass the turn to you.
I draw a card. And then here, I think that we just play... Liliana.
Okay.
And all minus.
Sacrifice.
And it's your turn.
Fetch. 22.
Dose, dose.
And we'll just get another snow covered island.
Snow covered island.
Yep. Alright. We will draw for turn. Oh, that's not. Not what we were looking for. And we're just going to run it and hope.
Right, well, this game played out exactly how I hoped it would. when I took the card I took with the Inquisition. So that's always a good feeling. All right, so let's do... I think that I want to have this in play and discard this. So we'll start by plussing the Liliana.
Okay. Discard a Sacred Foundry.
I'll shock.
13.
Then we'll terminate the Swans and cast an Ooze and Pass.
Go.
I draw a card. Man, I just keep drawing these good cards. rough life, right?
Gotta suck, yeah.
Let's see here. So I guess it's... Right, well, I'm going to plus the Liliana.
I will path your Ooze in response.
Alright, so Ooze gets pathed. Get to go get a forest. No, I don't. I get to go get a swamp because I discarded the forest.
I don't even think what a good draw for me here would be. Snapcaster Mage, probably. Probably the best draw for me.
Discard this Terminate for my Liliana.
Goyf. Bob. Another
Ooze. Play a Scavenging Ooze.
Alright.
And I think that I just want to... well, actually, I'll just sit on it, just in case you draw a Snap.
Okay.
So I'll pass.
Soulfire. You're up.
Alright, well, let's get two of your creatures.
Yep.
Let's see here. So I think I just edict you. Just get your Soulfire. And I go up to 16. I'm gonna shock to 14, so I have more Ooze trigger Ooze thingies available. I'll eat my Bob.
Okay. So you're at 15.
Go up to 15.
I'll take 6.
So there's 3, 4, 5. And then you take 7.
I path one of these.
Oh, yeah. So you take 6.
Yep.
16?
Yep.
Pass.
All right.
No Ojutai.
Go. It's not Ojutai.
Let's get Path and Bolt out of there. Six.
10.
Play a Tarmogoyf.
Yep.
And then I'll pass. So it's instant sorcery.
Plus.
Plus the Leon in the pass.
Sure.
So it's instant sorcery land. There's no more creatures. So it's a 3-4.
Pass.
I'll plus the Leona.
I'll pass Scavenging Ooze.
Swamp Forester. I don't have any more basics, so I'm just not going to shuffle.
Okay.
Attack for 3.
I'm at 7.
And I'll pass.
Go. Sure.
Plus Ileana, attack for 3.
I'm at 4.
Go.
Alright, I'm dead.
Alright.
Alright, we're here for game 4. I have the dubious honor of again being on the play, and all right, this is a hand. I'll keep it.
Man. All right, I kind of want to keep this hand, but I don't think that I can. And the only reason I kind of want to keep it is because I have this card, which is just very good in this matchup. So.
Tilt.
I bet you can figure it out. I'll give you a clue. If there's a hand that is only one spell that you would keep with this deck in this matchup, what would that hand be?
What would that spell be?
Yeah.
Liliana?
No, it's just like six lands, terminate with a rage movie.
Oh, okay.
I'll ship it.
I was thinking Liliana. Would be good. Just
five spells on top of my deck.
Had it.
All right, we're back for six, and... All right, yeah, this hand's fine.
All right, 17. I'm going to have to, because it's Arid Mesa, the worst land in the deck.
Well, you already have eight blue fetches, though, right?
That's true, I do.
And you could play Polluted Delta.
Nah, Arid's better than Polluted Delta, but my hatred for Arid Mesa is at an all-time high.
You could always just play Mystic Monastery if you wanted.
It's true. There's got to be some snow lands. Why don't we just play the Boreal Shelf or whatever?
The blue-white snow land.
Yeah, all right. So I'll draw from Sarum and then scry two. Kind of want both of these, I think.
Oh, rats.
Yeah, we'll just keep them both. Right. You're up.
Land? Go ahead.
All right, so... Serum again, draw fine. This, and scry two. I think I just don't want either of these, so we'll just bottom both of those. And place the event and say go.
No, it's not bad.
Old Bob.
Old Bobby.
Well, he's going to get... Oh, hey, that's cool. Soulfire, Snowland. The old Scred for one. 18 life. You're up.
I feel... disgusted.
By what just happened?
Yes.
Getting your Bob Scredded?
Yeah. I'll eat it too.
Sacrifice.
Well, Twilight Mire putting in some work over here.
It that's what it does.
Scred for one. Kill your Dark Confidant. Just right. How they drew it up when they designed that card in R&D.
Here, I just want to fetch down to 17. Yeah, 17. Let's get a snow-covered island. And actually, I think that I just say go. Yeah, I'm just gonna say go. Here, go.
Draw a card.
Sure.
Man, that card is sweet. I think that I just want all of these cards.
Tilt.
I still want to use my Liliana. Alright, so it's 17 to 20?
Yep.
Plus the Liana.
Yep.
Now I have to decide what I want to get rid of here.
These are my three best cards, so this is an easy discard.
I think that I can just get rid of this.
Explosives.
Alright, so we're gonna float a black, and I will Thoughtseize you.
Well, that's unfortunate. I will Vendilion click you in response to the Thoughtseize. Or Vendilion click in response to the Thoughtseize.
Okay. The click will resolve.
Target you.
I'll use the black floating and a red to terminate the Vendilion click. Hold on, you still get to click me.
I do. Yeah, that's right. Get rid of Quilligan's Command.
Yeah, like, my hand was just great.
Jeez. Well, my hand was great until that series of events happened, so.
I guess I just have to take the Snapcaster Mage. Leave you with the path.
Yep.
So I go to 18.
Yep.
And then I'll pass the turn.
All right. Come on, deck. Go.
Draw a card. I feel like I have to sit on this Liliana for a minute. But maybe I just plus and see what he does. Yeah, I'll plus the Liliana. And we will.
I think I actually discarded this, so.
Get rid of. This.
Go. That's news.
You're news. Huh?
But I'll remand it. So I kept remand over path because I wanted to just.
I discarded the glyph.
Yeah.
And then I'll pass. Okay. I guess you know.
Draw. Oh, so he has. Snapcaster, Serum Visions.
Yep.
Might not be the best use of Snapcaster Mage, but.
Well, you know I have an Ooze and a Liliana in play. You're kind of in a rough spot.
Yeah. I do want both of these cards, but neither of them are going to win me this game. So we have to hope that whatever's beneath these cards is going to be good and that he doesn't draw very well. So. I think I want them in this order. You're up.
So I'll draw. And I think that I don't think that I want to. I just want to eat him and then play a scavenging news. That could just be wrong though. Yeah, I will edict you.
Okay.
Cast news.
Sure.
And I'll pass.
Go.
We'll eat your Snapcaster Mage.
Okay. So you're at 19?
Yep. Alright. I'll plus. Get rid of this. We'll have a green floating, and I'm going to terminate the swans. I'll eat the swans. Go up to 20, and then I'll attack you for 4.
13.
Go ahead.
Go.
I'll plus the way off.
No path and response. So I knew with Swans plus Path on top of my deck that I wasn't going to pull ahead, but I was at least going to...
I think that I should eat some stuff here, so I'm not actually going to cast anything.
Sure.
So let's do...
You need 3 things.
Yeah. I guess I'll get your Serum Visions. Let's see, Scred's going to kill almost everything. I'll do the remand. And Scred.
Scred. Okay.
Yeah.
So that guy gets passed.
I need to go get a swamp.
And you have to discard.
Discard the land. And then it'll be your turn.
Alright, so we're still alive if we draw some sweet gas. Draw. Go.
Tasker. You have a land over there?
Yeah, it lands over here.
I'll get rid of. I think I'm fine with like everything that you could give me back. So I think that I just do this. I just don't want Thoughtseize.
Alright, I'll remand your Tasker. Draw.
I think that I want to use a Leon here, so I'll just pass.
Okay.
One of the hidden modes of the Leon, I'm just doing nothing.
Well, that's pretty awkward. I'll play explosives on 3. And now I have to decide whether I want to actually just immediately blow up this Liliana or not. Because that pulse is kind of annoying. But yeah, we'll do it. Blow up the Lily and you're up.
You have one card?
Yep.
Combat.
I'm at 9. And you're at 22.
Yep. Good.
Alright, come on, top deck. Alright, let's...
We have Swans and Scred. Can you draw 3 cards?
I did not draw Scred. However, I did draw Lightning Bolt. So I'll play Swans.
So you get to draw 3?
I'll bolt it. Draw 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. Alright. That's a...
We need to go get a snow-covered mountain and draw 4.
Alright, so I gotta think of how to play this out. Because I am at 9, so this is actually...
So you're just dead to... Well, I guess you're not dead, but...
Okay. Alright, so I have 1, 2, 3... Let's fudge down to 8.
We drawn 5 cards.
Yeah, we're gonna Scred or Swan. And draw 5 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You gotta be kidding me.
You just dropped 5 lands.
Come on, deck.
Okay.
Just give me one break.
Alright, well I can just put you at 1. And then play this Bob. I think it's probably fine. I guess I can't play the Bob with my pulse. Yeah,
All right.
Put you at one.
Put me at one.
Go ahead.
All right. Soulfire Grandmaster, come on. Okay. Play Swans.
Yeah.
Lightning Bolt my Swans. One, two, three.
Did we do it?
I think I tapped wrong. Definitely tapped wrong. Serum Visions. I've already played a land, right? I think I did. Draw.
Yeah, I think you played a snow-covered island.
Alright, bottom this.
Yeah, you went up to. You only had five snow-covered lands last turn.
Top this. Alright, you're up.
I'll fetch.
Alright, I'm dead. If I had tapped red, I would be fine, but I didn't.
Oh, you have two red spells?
Yeah.
Oh, you'd be able to scred. Yeah, you could scred bolt block.
I could, yeah, I could like, bolt,
oh, yeah,
spread.
You would have had to cast the swans with all four blue mana.
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh, well, I'm dead. All right, we're here for the next game, and hopefully I can muster something a little bit better this time. And this hand's fine, so I'll keep.
Well, this hand was fine on 6 and great on 7, so I'll keep.
Must be. You're up.
Well, Inquisition.
Lightning Bolt or Path?
Huh. Let's take the Lightning Bolt. And then I'll pass.
Alright, I don't really want to fetch here, because I don't know what I need to get with this land yet. So, let's draw. And I might need to pass, so play this.
Good.
Yep, that's really frustrating. Draw. And path the Bob.
Yep.
I hate pathing here, but it's better than him getting cards.
I'll go get a swamp. That's why I took the bolt instead of the path.
Inquisition into Bob is the bane of decks like this.
Yeah.
It just always has been. Or Thoughtseize into Bob or whatever. Just discard spell into Dark Confidant. It's been the bane of decks like this for a very long time.
Or really anything that's just like trying to one for one.
Yep.
It really sucks because you can't wait for the my upkeep to deny me the extra mana as well. Because
it still triggers, yeah.
Yep. Alright, draw. Alright, I'll fetch. We're going to go to 17, and I'm going to play a Huntmaster.
Sure.
I think that I want to get a red.
Alright, I'm going to fetch a snow cover now.
A red-green land. Now we'll gain 2 life, go back up to 19. For a second, I thought you were giving my deck back that quickly.
Alright, so you're 19, I'm at 18.
Yeah, I'm 19, you're 19?
I'm at 18.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you fetched it.
Yep.
And we'll get a cute little wolf.
Okay, I will draw. Alright, play Ace Wands. You're up.
Tap. We'll draw a card. You have 3 cards?
Yep.
Huh. Well, this is interesting. I don't have a way to kill the swans currently.
Perfect.
However, I can just Ancestral Recall, which is probably going to be correct. So I'll do three to your swans.
Okay.
I'll draw one, two, three. And we did not draw a way to kill the swans.
Perfect.
However, we did hit some decent stuff, so I will thought seize you. We have another swans. Right, well, I'm going to go to 9 or 17 from the thought seize, and I don't know what to take.
They're all good cards, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so I think that what I do is I take the Ojitai. And I take the Snapcaster Mage and go to 13. Or 15, sorry.
Yep.
And then I attack with my wolf.
I'm at 16.
And then I'll play a Scavenging Ooze and pass the turn.
Okay. Draw. I'll Snapcaster Bolt my swan. One, two, three. Interesting draws. I'll play Flooded Strand. Attack for four.
11.
You're up.
Draw a card.
Swans is such a weird card.
I could have just not played the second Thoughtseize and played the Ooze and left up a green mana.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been the same as countering a Snapcaster Mage. That would have been the right play. Okay. So I think what I do is... that.
Okay.
I will go to combat.
Sure. I'll block the wolf.
Okay. So you'll take two.
Actually, should I? I don't think I'm supposed to block. I'm not supposed to block.
Like if you don't have a way to stop Liliana, I don't think I would block.
Yeah, I'm just going to take it. Take four. I'm at 12. Unless you want to eat something.
I think that I might.
Yeah, I need the Snapcaster's Liliana proof. Plus, if he doesn't play a creature, I can actually attack with it because he's not going to want to trade his Huntmaster for it.
Actually, I don't want to eat anything, so you just go to 12.
All right, 12 to 11.
Here, I'm just going to pass the turn.
Okay, I'm just going to untap. And all
right, so this will trigger.
Oh, wait, hold on. That's going to trigger. Sorry, I can't do that then. I have to fetch down to 9. I forgot about that, yeah.
You're going to 9?
Yeah.
Rats.
I'm going to get Sacred Foundry and Lightning Bolt my swans.
All right, I'm going to respond.
Sure.
I want to be able to bolt into a Terminate if I need to.
Do you have another bolt?
No, but I have a Cold Gates command.
Okay, sure.
Man, I wanted this Huntmaster to flip real bad. Alright, so this guy's actually still tapped, technically. Alright, well, we're going to respond, and I'm going to Colgan's command to do 2 damage to this and make you discard a card.
Well, I don't think that this is going to do it in the face of the scavenging ace, so discard a Snapcaster.
Draw two.
Yep. Brick. Brick.
Yeah, you get to draw three.
Alright, on top.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. That was good. Our draw, we drew three cards that are okay, so draw this. Ooh, spice. Some spice there. Oh, I'm gonna lightning bolt swans. 1, 2, 3. Well, that was really bad. Alright, so I'm at 9, you're at 11. Mm-hmm. Alright, so play a land, attack with swans.
7.
I kind of just want to play this other swans to just threaten lethal. But he might have like Maelstrom Pulse or something too. I think maybe a better play is to just do this. I don't know what to do it on though. Probably 0. Maybe I do it on 0 and cast the other swan. Ugh. Yeah, I'll explosives for 0. So that can kill his wolf or his huntmaster if he flips it. And I actually think I just say go. Go.
I'll eat your Ojitai.
Okay.
Go to 8.
Yep.
Let's see. Do I want to fetch? That opens it up. Me up to another Snapcaster Mage. I just want to fetch.
Okay.
I'll go to combat.
Sure.
I'm just going to send everything.
Okay. I will block Huntmaster with Snapcaster Mage. And that's my only block. Probably should blow this explosives. I'm trying to think what else of 0 we would have to blow up. Just to save us some damage. Yeah, I'll blow the explosives. And then still ready for damage or
Bleachers, Snapcaster Range.
So you go to 9, and I take 4 down to 5.
Yep.
All right, these guys trade off. I'll remand your Tarmogoyf.
Man. I didn't want to have to go down to 6 to replay this Tarmogoyf. So if I don't replay the Tarmogoyf, then I just get brick-walled by his other swans. But if I do replay the Goyf, I'm just dead to another Lightning Bolt. Oh, you have what, like one bolt left?
Okay, so there's 3. One Snapcaster,
one snap, bolt. One bolt left. Yeah, I'll go 6.
Good.
Do you have the snap or the bolt?
No. But awkwardly enough, I drew explosives off of remand.
Wow. Well, the Goyf is huge, but I don't think it matters.
Draw. No, it's going to get blown up. Let's see. 5. Oh, there's Raging Ravine in the mix.
Maybe I shouldn't have attacked with the Huntmaster for that reason. I don't know.
I'll play explosives on 2.
Yep.
Attack you with Swan.
I'll go to 2.
And I'll pass the turn. My hand being extremely awkward right now. Hopefully this explosives is good enough.
Instant sorcery creature land.
Artifact.
Yeah, so it's just a 5.
Pretty sure there's no downside to waiting on this explosives. Got it. Let's go ahead and blow up explosives.
Okay. So let's...
They're super dead. Is it Lily? Kitchen things, okay.
Go up to 4.
Sure. Scavenging is. Alright. Alright. Draw a card. Alright. Well, step one, I guess. Spread this thing.
For how much?
I should probably fetch first, actually. That puts me down to 4, but that's fine. Yeah, I'll fetch. So I'll go to 4 and get a snow-covered mountain and spread it for a lot.
Oh, well, I'm going to terminate in response.
Are you really?
No.
I didn't think so.
Draw 7 cards?
1, 2, 3. Yep, draw 7. I'll Wheel of Fortune myself. Alright, so this is like dig through time, except I just get to keep them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, oh yeah, you know I have this. I drew this, but I'm just going to do this because it's the correct play. So Serum Visions, draw, and then Scry 2. Just basically, I wanted to find this card, which I did. And then Staring Visions again. Draw, scry two. Don't need this, but do want that. Attack you with swans.
I'll try and eat a creature.
Sure.
So to one.
And then I will lightning bolt you.
You just need to find a bolt or a snapcaster mage.
Yeah, I knew that, but I wanted to. Just the safe play is to find the Stubborn Denial first.
So yeah.
Really, no drawback to doing that. So. Man. All right, so Swans did not pass the Jund test.
No.
It did not. There were some interesting games, some fun things happened. I definitely punted game four by not leaving up two red sources. Maybe win that game. Still not.
Yeah.
Still, I mean, you still get to draw like three cards off your Kitchen Finks, so anything could have happened there. But
that's rough.
I don't know. It was definitely an interesting game or interesting match. A lot of cards being drawn on both sides. I got to do some sweet things. This deck is pretty sweet. Like, you get to do some cool things.
Definitely looks really fun to play.
Yeah, it's really awkward though. A lot of the draws. The mana is really gross when you play 9 basics in your deck. You're going to have some really awkward hands with mana. So mana was kind of gross, and I think you should just be main decking Blood Moon if you're going to do that to your mana base.
Probably.
Like, just play Blood Moon in the main deck. If your mana base is already going to be just disgusting like this, like, we might as well have a payoff for it beyond just Scred. And honestly, I don't think Scred is worth it.
Yeah.
I think you can just play, like, Bolt, Helix, Electrolyze, and
with swans.
Yeah, you don't need Scred. You can just play like Colonnades and like an actually decent mana base.
So you're just like a Jeskai control deck with the swans combo?
Yeah, I think that's like a reasonable place to be. I mean, I did get to like draw 7 cards off the Scred on my swans, which was pretty sweet, but most of the time when I was Scredding, or most of the time when I was like hitting my swans with stuff, it was like a Bolt or Scred was only like 3 anyway.
Yeah.
So I think that, yeah, you might as well, like, I don't think the payoff for Scred's worth it unless you're also playing Blood Moon.
Yeah, I could see that. Plus, like, this deck is pretty immune to Abrupt Decay. So, you know, even if you have Blood Moons in your main deck and they keep their Abrupt Decays in, you know, there's going to be a percentage of games where they just have, like, dead Abrupt Decays and die because of it.
Yeah, I mean, so, or they're killing a Snapcaster or something.
Yeah.
I mean, it does kill Soulfire Grandmaster, but that's about it.
Yeah, this really is about it.
Yeah. Dragonlord Ojutai seems interesting. Didn't really do that much here, though. But
yeah,
it did like pressure your mana.
A little bit. I feel like Primeval Titan is putting a stranglehold on the format and making people lean towards hard removal spells like Terminate. And so playing something that's vulnerable to that is really not where I would want to be come Charlotte.
Yeah.
To be honest.
Yeah,
like,
I agree.
It's gonna be a lot of Terminates. I mean, you might even see something like Doomblade as well start seeing play.
Yeah, like the danger of Ojutai is it does dodge a lot of removal, but it doesn't dodge Terminate, and it's really gross against Liliana. And like,
yeah,
the thing about playing against decks like Jund is they get to see your hand so many times that you're never going to surprise them with Ojutai, like, unless you just peel it off the top or something.
Yeah.
Like, they're going to see it. If it's a problem for them, they'll take it with Thoughtseize. But if they have like Liliana and Terminate, like, they're just gonna take your other cards. You're gonna be stuck with a clunky 5 drop in your hand, and like, by the time you can even cast it, it's not gonna do anything. So,
I know that Jeff Hoogland has been trying to play Ojutai very exclusively in Modern online, and he's even going so far as to use cards like Manamo to untap it, and Slayer Stronghold to give it Vigilance.
Yeah.
So, like, I think if you want to be on Ojutai, that's the route that you would need to be, as opposed to just kind of, it just feels kind of forced into this deck.
Yeah, I don't think that you want to be on Ojutai. That's my opinion, is I actually think that, like, Blue-White X control decks are the worst best decks in the format. Like, they're the worst decks that people play, like, that people will actually play in tournaments.
Mm-hmm.
I strongly advise against playing something like Blue White Red at Charlotte. I mean, this deck is different. It's kind of a different shell, but like the standard Blue White Red control, like,
yeah,
I would not want to touch that with like a 10-foot pole for a tournament like Charlotte. Like, you don't have a good Jund or Junk matchup, and you don't have a good matchup against like these land based combo decks like Tron.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, I don't think you have a good matchup against the decks you're supposed to beat either. Like, I think that the like even the Collective Company decks are very favored against Blue White Red Control.
Yeah.
So, that's my feeling. I think if you're doing Blue White Red, you should be doing something like this or something with Geist or a more aggressive bent. But even then, just play Jund, like, or one of the unfair decks. But
yeah. Now I know that Sean McLaren, our resident Jeskai master here on the premium side at StarCityGames.com, recently wrote an article this week about a bunch of different Jeskai decks.
Yep.
One of which was just like a control deck with the Kiki Jiki Resto combo in it. So I think that, you know, if you're going to play some type of Jeskai deck, it can't just be like straight up hard on control. Like, you have to have, you know, some type of combo, whether it be Swans or Kiki Jiki.
Yeah, I agree with that, but even then, I think it's better to just play a different deck. I mean, Sean has a little bit of a personal attachment to Jeskai, but yeah. I don't think that Jeskai's well positioned right now.
Fair enough. As for Jund, I think it is always well positioned.
Yep. Classic Jund.
You know, we saw some Abzan decks kind of crop up as ways to beat, you know, beat the green black X mirror with something like Lingering Souls, since it's very good against Jund. But then you're just lacking against the majority of the field. So I think that if you want to play Abrupt Decay and Liliana, Jund is the way to go. And I really like something along the lines of this deck that Josh Rabbit's played, or something like what Jerry Thompson has been pushing online with, like, Leyline of the Void in the sideboard and Ghost Quarters in the main.
Yeah, and I think that Jund actually isn't even, like, it's like 55-45 in Abzan's favor against Jund. Like, it's not even, like, a blowout matchup.
Yeah.
Even with Lingering Souls, they don't always draw it. A lot of the Jund lists are now playing things like Chandra, which is really good against Lingering Souls. And, you know, like, there's just Olivia or Grim Lavamancer or all these other ways to combat it, or just being super far ahead on board, because Jund's a much faster deck than Junk. So, yeah, I think that Jund's just the better of the Abrupt Decay Liliana decks.
For sure. Now, we will be in Charlotte this weekend, so make sure you stop by and say hello. In addition to that, we will be there on Friday filming the pregame show. So that will be filmed live and then recorded to be played later on, you know, in the weekend. But make sure you come hang out with us on Friday. You can check out, there's Brian Kibler and Patrick Chapin will be there doing some things. There will be a meet and greet with Patrick Sullivan and Cedric Phillips, our esteemed commentators that you guys see every week on SCG Live. And then we'll be doing the pregame show with Cedric and Patrick, along with all of the worst video guys, myself, BBD, Tom Ross. Well, no, I don't think Tom's on it, but Brad and Todd are.
Yep.
Tom will be there.
Yeah, Tom will be there. Yeah.
He'll definitely be there, so make sure you stop by and say hello, as well as to tune in this weekend on SCG Live. If you're not able to make it out to the Grand Prix in Charlotte to battle, we will be bringing you all 15 rounds plus the top 8 action.
Yeah, if you like Modern, this is a good chance to get some more Modern.
I mean, everybody loves Modern. Like, it's very obvious weekend that everybody loves Modern.
I mean, Modern's just probably the most popular format right now, even more than Standard.
It really is.
Yeah.
Which is, I don't know, kind of makes me happy, especially now that I found a deck that I like.
I didn't
really have a deck that I liked before, so it was just kind of like, I have to play this. But now it's like, all right, yeah, we get to play Primeval Titan.
I hope they ban the deck you like. I'm just going to say that right now. It is only fun for one player at the table.
The same could be said for just gaining infinite life.
Infinite life's so easy to beat. Almost every deck in the format can beat infinite life. I'm not even joking.
I don't think they should have to, though.
It's so easy to beat, though. It really is. Like, it's not even a thing.
We will be back next week filming another Versus video. Not sure what format we're going to play, so make sure you make your voices heard. The Open Series is going to be going back to Standard for a bit.
Yep.
But we do have Modern and Legacy, Premier IQ, 5Ks. So we're down for doing anything, really. So just make sure you let us know what you want to see in the comments.
Yep, definitely.
For those of you who are watching on YouTube and not on StarCityGames.com, underneath our smiling faces, there should be some things you can click on to see previous BBD versus CVMs. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel, as well as let us know what you think in the comments, because we do read the YouTube comments in addition to the StarCityGames.com comments, for better or for worse.
Yep, and actually a lot of people wanted to see the Jeskai Swans deck, which is why I played it, because there were at least two or three comments about it, so we do actually read those.
Yep, and I did want to play amulet against it, but that did not seem like it would be very interactive or fun for any of us. So
no.
We decided to go with good old Jund.
Yeah. And they were actually good games. So
actually were. Even though it seemed a little one-sided from the results, the games were, pretty much back and forth for the most part.
Yep.
So thanks for coming and hanging out with us, and we will see you guys this weekend in Charlotte and next week on your computers.
See you.